Hey guys, welcome to Draw My Story. And here's the shout out to those amazing fans of Draw My Story who've sent in their fan arts. They're beautiful. Thank you guys for sending. If you also want your arts to be featured in my video, then please follow the instructions of how to send in your fan art. It's in the video description below. Love you guys. And today, we're drawing the story of another weird and mysterious giant. It's dangerous and huge. The name is Slithering Doom. The Slithering Doom is a humongous dinosaur-like creature who comes under the giants category. It's supposedly a sauropod. Sauropods are a species of dinosaurs. The Slithering Doom has a physical appearance very similar to sauropods. That means it has a very long neck and a long tail. The head is relatively small compared to the other parts of the body. The creature has four thick, pillar-like legs. The sauropods were the largest among the dinosaurs in their age. Similarly, the Slithering Doom is the largest giant among all the giants who've reached the Earth. Apart from the main four legs, there are numerous tentacle-like structures spouting out of its body. These tentacles run through the lower torso portion of the Slithering Doom's body. The Slithering Doom is always seen near water. There's a need for this monster to be near water. It always slithers in the waters and emerges up like a moist snake. As the name suggests, this monster slithers and comes out in gloomy and cloudy days. The dinosaur-like creature's silhouette is what is visible for the public. It will be seen far away at the end of any water body. Sometimes it appears in the ocean, and sometimes in a lake or pond. The creature is never seen on land bodies or at close distance. It's observed that the Slithering Doom can walk on water with its tentacles floating around inside the waters. This monster disappears down inside the water once its time is done. So, is this giant the same as all the others? Did it also reach here through summoning? Yes. The Slithering Doom has also reached Earth by the prayers of the moon worshippers. However, this giant is different from all others in many ways. First of all, the Slithering Moon does not attack any humans directly. It only ascends them. The Slithering Doom is here to take the humans to the other side. They're taken as it is, physically, along with their spirit bodies. The humans who are supposed to be taken by the giant are drawn towards the creature. It's seen that when a person gets a calling for ascending with the Slithering Doom, he or she will walk towards the water body where the monster is slithering. It's like they intuitively know where it is. Once they reach the shore, the humans will jump inside the water and swim towards the silhouette visible from the shore. Those who do not have a calling might try to stop these people or try to save them. However, these humans are determined to reach the monster. They will have immense strength at the moment. Nothing can stop them. They will cross all barriers and keep swimming towards their destination. Once they reach near the monster, it will lift them up using its tentacles and keep them on its back. The humans will be sitting on the doom's back, getting ready for a ride. After collecting many humans, the creature creates a whirlpool in the water where it's standing. The pool will start slowly, only to become stronger, like a fast-spinning washer. Once it reaches a super-fast stage, the Slithering Doom, along with the humans, will descend into this whirlpool and disappear. After some time, the water will settle down to its normal flow. When it's time for the monster to come back again, first a whirlpool is created by itself. Then the monster emerges through the center and reaches the water surface. It will start walking around on the water surface, again waiting for the destined humans to reach him. So, what happens to the humans who are taken inside the waters? Through the water, there is a divine portal through which the humans are sent across. Water is the source of power for the Slithering Doom. This monster draws its powers from the water. It can attract humans towards it and send them to the other side, only because of its close affinity with water. If at all, the Doom is taken away from its water habitat, it will not survive on Earth. Within seconds, the giant will go powerless and die. The slithering motion itself indicates that this giant is made to work along with the element of water. The Slithering Doom has the ability to make slither noises, like a snake. It's assumed that this monster has a long tongue inside its mouth. There's no solid evidence for this. However, the similarity of the creature with snake made the researchers to conclude that there can be tongue which has poison inside it. So the monster can bite and induce poison on anyone. However, there's very less chances for this feature being used on humans by this giant. The Slithering Doom is not a destructive giant. It is the biggest among the giants, but surely it is the most harmless. There is no fear or anxiety around this monster's existence. People have come to understand that those who have to go with the giant will know it for themselves, and there's no point in stopping them. Basically, the poisonous tongue is a defense mechanism for the giant, and it's understandable that such a harmless monster can be targeted by other monsters who want to take the whole Earth under their control. They might attack the giant. However, the Slithering Doom knows how to protect itself. Apart from the poison, the monster also has the ability to fly. Yes, that's a surprise, but it's true. This fact is mostly hidden. Sometimes the monster is seen up above the water surface. It looks like he's doing a gentle hop, but this is actually the giant flying with its wings. These wings are invisible. In no photograph, the image of the wings is captured. However, many analysis says strongly that the monster is not hopping, but flying. So it must have the ability to fly at any height as per the need of the hour. A flying monster with a poisonous tongue is definitely good enough to kill any other giants. And that was today's story, guys, about Slithering Doom. Comment and let me know, how'd you like it? And please subscribe to my channel, guys, if you want to see more Draw My Story horror videos like this one. Till then, bye.